sold out marine squads to maintain order and enforce the law. Today, Quarian marines have evolved training and tactics akin to civilian police, but remain adept at combat in the confined spaces of a starship and fully under the command of the military. Once taken into custody, the accused is brought before the ship's captain for judgment. While the ship's council may make recommendations, tradition holds that the captain has absolute authority in matters of discipline. Oh, don't tell me they can frickin' just shoot you out the frickin' lock, the airlock. That'd be awesome. And awesome in a shit way. Most are lenient, assigning additional or more, odious, okay, maintenance tasks aboard the ship. Persistent, what? Recidivid, what? I've never seen that fucking word in my life. Are accidentally, quote unquote, left on the next habitable world. Oh, okay, so they don't just fucking outright kill them. That's good. This practice of abandoning criminals on other people's planets is a point of friction between the Quarians and the systems they pass through. I can understand that. Captains rarely have another choice. With space and resources at a premium, supporting a non-productive prison population is not an option. Okay, yeah, I get that. Which is why I would ask, well, why not just kill them? And I'm not saying they should. I'm just saying that would be what I would have assumed. They would just, like, shoot them out into space so they can float off and, you know, implode on themselves. But at least they seem to be, you know, not that much of an ass cheek when it comes to that sort of stuff. In the early years, many Quarian freighters were armed and used as irregular privateers. Civilian ships still show a strong preference for armament, making them unpopular targets for pirates. Though they have rebuilt their military, there are still mere hundreds of warships to protect tens of thousands of ships. The Quarian Navy follows strict routines of patrol and takes no chances. If the intent of an approaching ship can't be ascertained, they shoot to kill. Holy shit. Religion? Okay, this might be interesting here. The ancient Quarians practiced ancestor worship, even after abandoning faith for sacrilegious. that Quarians continued to revere the wisdom of elders. As time passed and technology advanced, they inadvertently turned their knowledge to preserving the personalities and memories of the elderly as computer virtual intelligences. These recordings became a repository of knowledge and wisdom stored in a central data bank and available through any extranet connection. Holy shit, I don't remember her talking about this. Maybe it's because I was, like, about to shit myself where I was sitting, so. They held no illusions that this was a form of immortality. Like all virtual intelligences, their electronically preserved ancestors were not truly sapient. This was considered a surmountable problem. Sapience could surely be reduced to simple mathematics. The Quarians began... I hear shit in the background. The Quarians began exhaustive research into creating artificial intelligence so they could learn to escape the bounds of mortality and give their ancestral records true awareness. Unfortunately, the life the Quarians created did not accept the same truths they did. The Geth destroyed the ancestor databanks when they took over. Oh, that's nice. That's like me freaking having my external hard drive, just having some twat come in the room and smash it with a hammer. In the centuries since they evacuated their homeworld, most Quarians have returned to religion in various forms. Many believe that the rise of the Geth and the destruction of their ancestors were chastisement for arrogantly forsaking the old ways and venerating, I guess, self-made idols. Others have a more philosophical outlook, believing that their race was indeed arrogant, but no supernatural agency lay behind the Geth revolt. Rather, the Quarians' actions wrought their own doom. Either way, every Quarian would agree that their own hubris cost them their world. And now we've got the Hall of the... What? Ablative? Is that what I'm looking at here? Ablative armor. A warship's kinetic barriers reduce the damage from solid objects, like ballistics, or I guess smashing into shit like asteroids, but can do nothing to block guardian lasers, particle beams, and other forms of direct energy weapon, or DEW. The inner layer of warship protection consists of ablative, again, I don't know, armor plate If that's a real thing in real life, I've never heard of it. Designed to boil away when heated. The vaporized armor material scatters a DEW beam, rendering it ineffectual. A scaffold is built around the interior pressure hull, with sheets of ablative armor hung from the structure. Ships typically have multiple layers of armor separated by empty baffles. It's called spaced armor in real life. Space is often used for cargo storage. Cruisers, which lack the internal space to fit dedicated fighter hangars, store the shipboard fighter complement in the battles. It is not unknown for enlisted crew to build illicit alcohol distilleries in some obscure corner of the baffles. Safe from prying. Are you serious? Priorities, man. Building a fucking distillery inside of a ship in between the cracks of the armor. How stupid is that? Ugh. Okay.
Pharos is a... Vermeyer is a lush world located on the frontier of the Attican Traverse. Its vast seas and orbital position on the inner life zone have created a wide equatorial band of humid, tropical terrain.
Ooh, I like this.
Only the political instability of the region has impeded efforts at colonization. Many times the Citadel has opened negotiations to settle Vermeyer with various criminal gangs and petty dictatorships in the nearby terminus systems. All fell apart due to internal power shifts within the opposing parties. The Citadel has written off the colonization of Vermeyer as impossible without significant political change. The Terminus powers themselves are unlikely to ever settle Vermeyer. Most lack the resources to support settlement of a virgin world, finding it more expedient to steal from their neighbors than build for themselves.
Twats. So we are going to go to a lush planet. A lush planet? In Mass Effect? Are you serious? Alright, now I'm excited. So yeah, we covered all that stuff. So let's go ahead and well, we have to do freaking inventory management first, though. That's the fun stuff right there.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. XO Presley stands relieved.
Take me down. No, don't take me down to the Paradise City. Please don't fucking start singing that. If there's any song that annoys the piss out of me, it's that one. I don't know why. I don't know. I don't want to get into some freaking song rant. I love music. Right from the 70s, the 80s, and the 90s, and the early 2000s. But the problem is there's a certain type of singing that was around in, like, the 80s that I can't really listen to all that well, and it's the one where their voices are like, you know what I mean? And that's exactly what that song is. And that's why I can't really do it. Oh, that is much better. I'll take it. There you go. Take that. I'll put shit on him here in a minute. But I think the reason why it was so annoying for me was because I played this game called Burnout Paradise, and that song literally plays on the menu every time you open it. Have mercy. Okay, now, let's take a look at our shit. Can I put another weapon mod? We should have some stuff. We could put some detection, weapon stability increase. Ooh, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Yeah, we got lots of weapon stability. I think weapon stability I should put on... Oh, wait. We've already got weapon stability. That's 18% weapon stability. Do we have a better one? We do. 21. Okay, I'm going to put that one on there. And then on this weapon, I'm going to put... I almost feel like... No, we shouldn't... No, fuck combat stuff. Real extensions, absolutely not. Oh, I've got two kinetic stabilizer sixes? Wait, hold on a minute. Did something fuck up there when I... No, I guess I had two. I didn't even know. Alright. Well, okay. I'll take it. Okay, and now for ammunition mods. So that's 30% versus tungsten rounds 5. Do we have any... We have tungsten rounds 6, 35 damage. Okay, I'll take it. And for the... Whoops. And then for this ammo one, okay, 25 versus synthetics. So that's tungsten rounds 4. We should have tungsten rounds 5, so I can place that. Proton rounds, no, plenty of Tungsten rounds are here. Okay. Good. And as for armor, I don't think any of my armor that I have is going to be anywhere freaking better than what I've got on now, so fuck off. Grenade mods, do we have any more incendiary? We have incendiary 6. Take it. Okay. Of course, our shotguns are always going to freaking be better, so you know what? Fuck you. I'm gonna put a shotgun on, because fuck it. And you know what? Actually, I should probably be checking. No, I don't think Tali's going to need a better pistol, but Liara's definitely not going to be using the one thingy. Okay, so do you have any better pistols at your disposal? 6. No, this is all 6 stuff, so it's not gonna... Why do I have a Kessler 1? no. Yeah, what she's got is good. And as for armor... She's got some good stuff on for right now, so I think she's covered. Alright, and Tali... Now, what about Garrus? Hold on, Garrus, you need to be checked. Alright, so I want you to be using... That, yeah, so you've only got a Tsunami 4, yet it's still better than all. Wait, no, Tsunami 6. Here we go. Good. So that should improve his garbage. And his armor, we already put that other armor on, so that we actually did get some use out of it. Now, how about his weapon mods? Let's switch to ammo first. So we have to go and track down a doctor. I feel like we're going to be fighting organics. So I think I should give him an organic. Increase the shredder rounds, I'm thinking. Yeah, fuck it. We've got plenty of shredder rounds. I'll give him one of those. And then as for your weapon, let's go ahead and give you... fuck it. I'll just put a combat scanner on there, because why the fuck not? Alright, and this Omni-Tool is better, so why not? Okay. So I want him to be using the assault rifle with me. Okay, so we should be good now. Which now means I get to do the fun shit.
Looking for supplies?
We get to make some of our money back.
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Alright. Heavy Krogan armor. Oh. Oh boy. Oh boy. What is that sound? Sounds like some vehicle in the back freaking parking lot just exploded. Okay. Omni-tool. 9 value. We're filthy fucking rich now. Biotic amp. No. I am selling, right? Yes, okay. So light armor is a Turian. Or it's human, not Turian. I think I should be working my way. Ooh. Oh my. Sell. Okay. Striker. It's a sniper rifle. Nope, sorry. Assault rifle. Of course, all of these are going to be nasty. Alright, tungsten rounds. Yeah, okay, these I want to be holding on to. So we'll go ahead and we'll sell both of these assault rifles. And work our way back down, and this will be the stopgap. So tungsten rounds, I'm gonna go ahead and not hold on to all of them, and since we've already got some, I'm gonna sell 2. And as for shredder rounds, I'm only going to have 1, and that 1 is currently being used by Garrus. And I just... Or should I hold on to 1 extra? I'll hold on to 1 extra for right now, just in case. I'll hang on to shield modulator 6. Rail extension, no. Shield modulator 6, another one. Or no, it went back down, okay. Rail extension 6, no. Proton rounds, 50%. I'll have to check Tali and see if this is better. I don't remember what she's got. She's got proton rounds, but I don't know if she's got proton rounds 6. Medical interface, that's not bad. I'll go ahead and hang on to one of those. Kinetic buffer, no. Incendiary rounds, no. Exoskeleton 6, no. Exoskeleton 6, no. Energized weave 6. Like the sound of that, so we'll sell 1. Cryo rounds, I'm never... Oh my good god. Just zip, 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 zip. Combat scanner 6, gonna get rid of that. Striker 6, snipe rifle, goodbye. Hammer, goodbye. Ursa, goodbye. Tornado, goodbye. I don't remember what Rex has. Fuck it, goodbye. We'll find better ones as we go. Okay, shotgun, shotgun, shotgun. Shotgun, 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 shotgun. And we've got lots of snippers. We obviously know none of these snippers are going to be better than what I've got, nor are the assault rifles. I've already checked everyone out for assault rifles, I believe. Light armor, not going to need that. More assault rifles, goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Turian armor, that's light, nope, fuck that. All these pistols, we've already checked all of the fucking pistols, so accept, 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 accept. Grenade upgrade, high explosive, fuck it. Heavy armor for me, it's not as good. Ammo upgrades, okay, so now we got tungsten rounds, so we've got tungsten 6 down here, so we can get rid of tungsten 5, we can get rid of shredder 5, we can get rid of shredder 5, we can get rid of shredder 5, we can get shield modulator 5, we can get rid of rail extension, because fuck them. We know we've got better proton rounds, polinium rounds. I'm going to hang on to that. Kinetic stabilizer. These are good, so I'm going to get rid of them. Incendiary rounds, I'm going to get rid of both of those. Energized weave 5, I don't need that. Cryo rounds, nope, not going to use them. Oh god, we got ablative coating. That actually sounds good. I'm going to hang on to one of those. We've got some snipers. Remember the Naginata? Oh, we'll never forget. Never forget. Okay, some Turian armor, get rid of that. Two more shotguns, two assault rifles, medium armor for a human, pistols and a biotic amp. I don't remember if we didn't check biotic amps on Liara, so I'll check that here in a minute. We'll get rid of incendiary explosive 5 because we've got a better one there. Plenium rounds 4, we don't need that. Tungsten rounds 4, no. Tsunami, okay, let's get rid of all those. Toxic seals, yeah, I'll hang on to one of those. And shield regenerator 3? Didn't we have a shield regenerator somewhere in here? Okay, now I'm gonna get rid of this one then. Okay, now. Let's check Tali and Liara one more time. So, Liara, you, biotic amp. What? No, that's an Omni tool. Okay, oh shit. She has an Omni tool as well. Fuck. I guess I should have checked that before I went and waffled it. Okay, let's see. So you've got Polaris 5. Oh, the Polaris Galaxy. Oh, I love it. It's one of my favorite galaxies in the Ratchet and Clank universe. Okay, now let me take a big old gulp from one of these 300 bottles here. She's got nothing better for her there. And what are you wearing right now? 100 shields? Well, let's put 110 shields on since we've got access to it. Okay, and then for Tali, you have energized weave 4, but we have energized weave 6, so you can have that. Okay, and now what are we doing? Right, and now on me, I forgot. What am I having? Okay, I have 5% damage track. I haven't upgraded this in ages. I have armor plating 1. So, what do we want? We could go for this one. That's what we're going to do. So now I have 12% protection. And now let's go and just sell off the rest of our little tidbits.
Looking for supplies?
This is all necessary.
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Okay, biotic amps and stuff in here. Okay. So, now armor plating 1, goodbye. Toxic seals 3, we'll hang on to that. Energized weave 4, goodbye. Solaris amp, yeah, all of these amps, goodbye. And we're done. Look at this, guys. Look at how much we've got here. We've only got freaking, what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We've only got freaking 7 things. How amazing is that? We have 1,040,000 credits. I think we made back our money. Maybe a little bit more. Okay. Now we get to look at our assignments. We get to see what we're going to do. Something's in my eyeball. Okay. What do we have now? No, that's not assignments yet, twat. Here we go. So, doctor at risk. Oh, wait, what is this? Garrus, find doctor. Oh, yeah, yeah. I didn't open it yet. Head to coordinates. So this is the one that I want to do. So this is Garrus's mission. And then we've got Doctor at Risk, which is Well, in Novaria, you found a log listing an unauthorized transmission. Apparently, someone thinks a doctor located in the Newton system is in grave danger. Unfortunately, it appears the message was intercepted by Novaria security before it could be delivered. So that is another thing that we had to do. In fact, that's it. That's all we have to do. Okay, good. So I want to do Garrus's mission first, because I think that'll be a little bit more interesting. Oops. Where is it located? First time you'll be okay. Head to the Herschel system in the Kepler Verge. Okay, so we haven't been to the Kepler Verge yet, I don't think. So this is going to be... I feel like there's going to be some Makoing coming. Wait, we went to the Hakinita, I know. The sentry system. Okay, I just wanted to double check. That's new. I don't remember that. Okay, well. Alright, here we go. Kepler Verge. There's the Newton system, and there's the Herschel system. Oh, wait, shit, that's the Newton system. Okay, Armstrong Nebula.
Message coming in from the brass at Arcturus.
What?
Patching it through.
Normandy? Admiral Hackett here. We're getting reports of a marked increase in geth activity in the Skillion Verge. Surveillance drones have identified geth outposts on four different planets in the Armstrong cluster. We need someone to take them out.
We have any idea what they're after?
Hard to say. They may be just gathering intel on us. Or maybe they're setting up staging grounds for hit-and-run attacks on human colonies.
It could be the first wave of an invasion.
Let's hope not. We need someone to investigate this, Shepard. Finding Saren is still your top priority, but you've got experience fighting the Geth. You're the logical choice to take out these outposts. We're transmitting all the locations of known Geth outposts in the Armstrong cluster to the Normandy now. Admiral Hackett out.
I don't want Hong. Where's Kong? Vamshi. Holy shit, okay, yeah, there's four systems here, and each one has got a thing in it. Crap, so I've just inadvertently walked myself into another mission. I came here because I knew we hadn't been here before, and so I was going to say, well, let's go check it out and explore it. Well, we're going to be here for a while, Misa thinks. What time are we up to? Alright, so the video should be splitting soon, so I'm going to stop it and just start it normally.